Music City is the center of the hockey world tonight. The Penguins take their 2-0 lead to Nashville. It is the first time they'll be hosting the Stanley Cup final in the country music capital. Good evening. I'm Paul Martino. The Penguins now just 2 wins away from repeating as Stanley Cup champs. But the Predators are on home ice tonight. They'll be backed by the boisterous fans in Nashville. Our Rich Walsh is there with his noise report.
People say this is the loudest building in the NHL. Game 6 of the West Finals was measured at 126 decibels. Now, to give you an idea how loud that is, PPG Paints Arena is around 110. Mike Sullivan and his players contend it won't be an issue.
I don't think it's a whole lot different. There's a lot of really good buildings in this league. There's a lot of really loud buildings in this league. And anytime you get this far, fans are going to be amped up and things are going to be exciting.
And no matter how loud it gets in here, the game plan doesn't change for the Penguins.
It's not like teams have two different game plans, one for home and one for the road. I think that's, you know, teams are trying to play to their strengths, regardless of where the rink is played or where the game is played.
The Pens have been really good at not paying attention to what Mike Sullivan likes to call outside noise, and there is definitely a lot of that in this city.
I think the guys last year experienced kind of the same thing, even though it wasn't in Nashville. There's a lot of hype wherever you are, so I think guys who have been in that situation before kind of know how to go about their day with that and not let it bother them.
Bridgestone Arena is still a few decibels away from being known as the loudest indoor arena. The University of Kansas holds that title. Allen Fieldhouse came in at 130.4 decibels when the Jayhawks beat West Virginia back in February. In Nashville, Rich Walsh, KDKA-TV News.